We're Ladi and Margaret, and we love e-bikes, campervans, and cats. We bought and built our last home for $6,000 US, but now stuck in a tiny village in the middle of nowhere, Czech Republic, we've decided to build ourselves an upgrade. With the help of some 3D printers and the ultimate workshop, we're building out a modern luxury van for full-time living and travel. Make sure to subscribe to the channel to watch the progress. Ready, Millie? Like for many people who are buying or building a van, we also plan to use this van as our daily driver. When we're going grocery shopping, going to the doctor's appointment, doing whatever we need to do, we will be taking the van with us. Therefore, we have decided to prioritize everything that we're doing within the cab. We're updating the doors so they don't make as much noise and they keep us a little bit toastier. We're adding a new monitor, and we're also gonna add in some new speakers. For the coming months, we've decided to keep that partition where it is, behind our two seats. And the reasoning behind that is when we're driving these short trips to and from the city, we don't want to be heating up a massive cargo van. We want quick heat, which the cab isolation is definitely useful for. It will also keep that whole front space really clean. We're going to be cutting holes in this van. We're going to be blowing stuff out, painting, spraying. We want to make sure that none of that gets on the dashboard. I think our plan for that partition is to take it down during the stage where we're installing furniture. That's also where we'll deal with those swivel seats. And if you're curious to where I'm standing, I call this the courtyard of the workshop. And I definitely want to talk more about some of the costs associated with the workshop and how we stay warm in the winter. Sound deadening and insulating the front doors is not very common, but we do believe that it will be helpful. If you plan to do this as well, make sure that you are insulating flat against the metal. This is the space where the window goes up and down, and you cannot have that interfering. That is so quiet compared to what it was before. Wow.
I'm curious what this is about.
Whoa! What?
This will be fun. Look how huge it is.
That's massive.
I love the controls right here. That's cool. And yeah, that's for different cars. That's for Volkswagen. So.
Wow.
I'll need to customize it. I'll probably take it out of the frame and then 3D print my own. These printers are like a blessing from God because we had to go through such a struggle last time. So the way we design is that we think about how we operate the space and how much we can utilize that space. So we thought through the storage containers on the side door. We knew what we want. We wanted 6 different pockets. And it was a mission what we had to go through to find product that has the same shape, but it's for a different purpose. So we bought the food containers. I had to reshape it and glue them. Took forever.
Where do we go? It was like IKEA, that grocery store, Hornbach. That thing is like a kitty litter, I think. This one.
This is a new addition to the van.
For our laptops.
Most unbelievable case. We went through all these places to find the right shape, right dimension, that would have a little space for screws. And guess what it is? A kitten litter.
You did good on the cutouts though.
That we reshaped.
The cutouts are really good.
But you found it. Now I can 3D print exactly what I want. We decided we were bringing one of these because throughout the time of living in a van, we're gonna add so much to that van. Mm-hmm. Plus, we're prototyping these e-bikes, so I always need to see physical objects to make adjustments based on.
Every little thing we want in that van, we can customize and print ourselves.
These 3D printers to me are absolutely nuts because I can create with my own thoughts a physical object through the machine. That object is duplicatable all over the world. How mad is the present moment? I went by your house, what a big mistake.
For a while I thought that I wouldn't break. There we go.
Someone to tell me how to live instead. The cover definitely needs to be shaped along this line, so that'll be a bit of a 3D modeling. So this will be my reference shape. A shot straight down, and I'm using this ruler as a reference to digitize my shape. And the same thing I'll do right here when I have again ruler as a reference, and then I can go around with my tool in a 3D and have exactly the shape of the frame. So now this should be in 1-to-1 ratio. That's great. So this is 100 mil in reality and this is 100 mil in my software. So now I can just go with the tool and copy this exact shape and 3D print a sample to make sure it fits. So many words that I should have said. Not concerned about how to live instead. Just open your eyes and take my advice. Stop pulling the dice and just compromise. I know these difficult ones fit, I can move on because, for example, this is digitizing a difficult part. So now I know I would have to be printing this shape and it would not fit. So I can easily customize this 10 minute template and I know it fits really, really nicely. And smarter, not pretty good. It's time to fit it for the first time. I'm curious whether this is gonna fit. Okay, here we go.
Shut up.
Whoa.
What? That is absolutely wild.
This is what I essentially thought, that I'll just use behind the nail amount of mammoth glue on both sides, or maybe four corners. Push it in with the masking tape here overnight, and that's it.
More about this workshop space. There's a reason I mention it in the introduction to all of these videos. This workshop is hands down our biggest advantage for this van build. Over the years, we've invested about $10,000 in all of the tools, supplies, and quirks of this space. One of the other major advantages we're working with is that we're in an affordable, trade-heavy community where tools and machines like these are very common, making them naturally cheaper. We love this place, but it's definitely its own project in a lot of ways. In some places, we're even missing ceiling. This is the land we spend all of our time on and definitely where all of our ideas come to life. In the future, we plan to build a small luxury apartment just on top of this workshop, so we only have to go up and down the stairs for a commute when we're visiting Czechia. That's well in the future. I can't even imagine the job of clearing out the yard of all the old scrap metal sheds and lumber storage. We kind of went back and forth for a while on how we were gonna do our curtains, because we've seen a lot of the amazing ones that people sell online with like magnets and such, but we want something a little bit bigger. So what we're thinking is make somehow some sort of a panel that replicates this, that like lives down here. It's insulated, it has our decoration on it, and then with some sort of a switch or a button, you click it and it automates its way up. And then like locks into place on a magnet or something. So that can be whatever color
absolutely
we have.
So what I'm thinking, I'll just need to make a support on both sides so he has something to slide in. And doesn't go up like this, and goes nice and evenly.
And then it's
Has
that air gap, has the insulation, and has the covering.
Yeah, that's gonna be probably 3-layer ply, and it's gonna be some insulation, some reflective foil, and probably upholstery or whatever decor we decide to do. And it's simple, with one actuator at the bottom, lifting it up. I think it's pretty easily doable.
So we'll have that on both sides, maybe, we haven't decided? We'll see, because we don't know if it will fit against that door yet. We don't know so much about how we're going to do this, but that is what we envision.
This pod supposed to have a retractable couch that's going to cover everything, and we don't mind it's going to be paneled. And let's show you the sofa, what we are planning right now.
This couch.
That's what we're going to have in a van. Isn't that horrible?
You might be asking, why would you ever put in a such a nice new van something this ugly? Because I'm not taking it for its aesthetics.
Yeah.
I only want the mechanism.
We want these guts.
So this is gonna look completely different. I want it a little bit wider, so it's probably this wide, and we're gonna just keep the frame, the metal frame that is behind all these ugly cushions. I'm gonna strip them off, throw them away, and make completely new ones from scratch. Take a look at a simple mechanism. This is just a metal wire as a release. And then you have this structure, so this complete backrest can go down and I can replace with anything custom I want. And look at this from behind. This is all that we want.
small jobs in the cab are a perfect way to continue moving forward with your van build project, even when you're waiting for items to be delivered to you in the mail. We have a lot coming to the workshop soon, including our 2 venting roof windows, 2 custom roof windows, and our solar panels. If you want details of what we're using and what we're plugging in, we have a full parts list of our van linked in the description. Ladi and Margaret.
So here's the front of the van and here is the back, and then we have the big window and a couch below it, and here is the rear smaller window, and a bed should be somewhere here. So these strips you see here, these are roof windows I just ordered recently.